Halo, welcome to 4B Module Technical Aspect Analysis. First, production planning. Production planning, according to Fogarty, Blackstone, and Hoffman, is a planning process using information from products to plan production rates and inventory levels over a period of time from a group of products. Production system. According to Stanford L. Opener, a system is defined as same going process of demands, each of which are functionally and operationally united in the achievement of objective. And this is production system scheme. The input, process, and output will be used for feedback for processing, controlling, and technology. Next is material planning. Material planning has been defined as the scientific way of determining the requirements of raw materials, components, and other items needed for production within the economic investment policies. It is rather a subsystem in the overall planning activity. Direct material cost planning. According to Barefield, Rayburn, and Kinney, direct material cost must be paid for the cost of all materials used in the manufacture of products or services for services. And this is a formula of direct material cost planning. Indirect material cost planning. Indirect materials are materials that usually not become part of the finished product. This has been defined as material that cannot be allocated but which can be shared or absorbed by the cost center or unit cost, namely as follows. 1. Material used in the maintenance of machinery, buildings, and so forth. 2. Material used by service department, that is non-productive departments, such as powerhouse, boiler house, and canteen, and so forth. 3. Materials which, because of their small cost, are not considered suitable to be treated as direct ingredients. This is formula for calculating indirect material cost. Investment cost planning. According to Kashmir and Jaafar, investment is placing money or fund in shares in an activity that has a relatively long period of time in various business fields. According to Fahmi and Hadi, investment is generally have two types. There are, first, real investment. Real investments generally involve tangible assets such as land, machinery, or factories. Second, financial investment. Financial investment in general involves written contract assets such as common stock and bonds. And this is formula for calculating investment costs. Depreciation. According to Surya, the definition of depreciation is the allocation of the amount that can be depreciated from an asset over its estimated useful life. According to the financial accounting standards for entities without public accountability, it states that this depreciation can be started when an available asset is used. For example, assets that are in the location and condition required so that they can operate as intended by management objectives. Factors in determining the appreciation cost of fixed assets. First is cost. The definition of cost is that money is spent or appears and other costs that occur in obtaining an asset and placing it so that it can be used. The second is residual value. The definition of depreciated residual value is what is received when the asset is sold, exchanged, or other means when the asset is no longer used, less cost incurred when selling or exchanging, and less estimated useful age or benefit period. This estimated useful life is an asset that is influenced by the way of maintenance and the policies adopted for reparation. This can be expressed in a period of time, units of production, or units of working hour. Depreciation method. According to Anthony Tarquin, there are classical internationally accepted depreciation methods used to determine depreciation. First is straight-of-line depreciation or SLD. Straight-of-line depreciation is a method of depreciation whereby equal portions of the amount paid for an asset are shown as an expense during each accounting period of the life of the asset. 2 is sum of years digits depreciation or SOYD. SOYD is an accelerated depreciation method. More depreciation occurs early in the asset's life than in its later life. 3 is declining balance depreciation or DBD. Declining balance method of depreciation is an accelerated depreciation method in which the depreciation expense declines with age of the fixed asset. Now we learn about cost of electricity machine. These electricity costs are costs that must be paid for each kWh use. And this is formula for cost of electricity machine. Maintenance. According to Basanta, maintenance is an activity carried out to maintain a production facility or repair the facility to an acceptable condition. The goals of maintenance. 1. To extend the useful life of the asset. 2. To ensuring the operational readiness of equipment in emergency activities. 3. To ensuring the safety of facility users. And 4. To ensuring the availability of equipment for production or services. This is last section of this module. Thank you and have a good study. Good luck!